Live from the Fox 5 studios, your local news, traffic and weather together. This is Fox 5 News This Morning.
Right, time once again to check in with our favorite guy in the morning, Ted Pretty.
He is live and he is entertaining. So, Ted, do we have to pay a tax for you?
No tax here that I'm aware of. This is your tax-free Foxcast for your weather for not only today but your weekend. I don't know what's more scary, this place, Hysteria City, or Snave, our audio guy's in-laws, who are in for the next, what did he say, 2 months? Oh, no, 1 week. He said it was going to feel like 2 months. Anyway, we'll talk to this mayor right here, maybe get a key to haunted the city right here, the Hysteria City, maybe later on.
Over the past 3 days, these semi-trailers have started their mutation into an evil city. Day four is here, and we can see some big changes. Scott's been busy building some of the interior sets for the haunted city. He's also been busy detailing trailer number four into the dark room. It even looks like he's done a little work on the Hysteria City Jail. The interior section of this city is really starting to take shape. But there's no time for patting ourselves on the back. We got a long ways to go and a short time to get there. The objective today is to finish detailing this section of the graveyard as well as finish up our jail cell. Wish Scott luck, because he's all alone on the build today. I think he's starting to crack. If this keeps up, they may have to take him away. Without notice, like a bolt of light, John, alias Gravely Rigor Mortis, appears, driving his beautiful black hearse Cadillac.
My name is John Powell. I'm into freaky things that you can see by my hearse here. I enjoy doing nothing. Yeah, that's basically what I get to join you and driving the hearse around, scaring people. Get to go home with my casket in the back. Uncle Ernie loves to see people. And opening the casket and showing them Uncle Ernie, well, I freak people out. They just don't want to get near the car and just scream and run away. It's great. Good clean fun. Uncle Ernie was the original gatekeeper to Hysteria City. He passed away so many years ago, and they found him when the city was opened up. So I've had the pleasure of showing around Las Vegas, Nevada. This place is amazing. What it was built with and from four semi-trailers, this is going to freak people out. And just loading up the hearse with, doesn't matter, PVC, plastic, screens, anything you can imagine, has been turned into what you see here, which is beyond what we started out as. Just a bunch of stuff people are throwing away. And now it's Hysteria City. It's amazing what Scott has done with this stuff. This will be an insane haunt. No two ways about it. Just looking around at what's up, and it's not even done yet. It's going to scare people. It's going to be good.
While John admires the city, Scott will get busy adding the awning for the La Vielle France Antique Store, as well as add some detail to his graveyard set. These once ordinary semi-trailers are now making a miraculous metamorphosis into a monster city.
Joining us now is Scott Michael, as he likes to be called Mayor Morbid, to tell us a little bit about Hysteria City. What sets Hysteria City apart as a haunted attraction as opposed to just a haunted house?
Well, we are a city of haunted attractions. We have 8 themed elements here at Hysteria City.
And we're going to take a look at it. I'm not going to go in just yet.
Welcome back to Monster City. It's day 5, and we can see there's been some more details added to our graveyard set. We've even brought in our mummies for this portion of the build. There's so much progress being made, it's almost scary. With all these demons, ghouls, and zombies, we're bound to scare up some business for the Halloween season. This graveyard set is almost a wrap, but there's still a lot to do. We've got the side facades, the front facades, the back facades, and let me think. Oh yeah! We've also got the electrical, the ticket trailer, and snack bar trailers to get done. We definitely better quit howling at the moon and start to get busy here in Monster City. It looks like Scott's attention has turned to the other side of the haunted attraction, the jail cell. Sitting in the hot seat today, we got William Giblin, veteran haunted house helper. He's worked for one of the biggest haunted houses in the world, Not Scary Farm. William came out today to check out the progress and get ready for his part in Hysteria City. We can see the electrical shock columns are in place, as well as a whole bunch of detail here in the jail area. I think William's happy. It looks like this day is a wrap. Sit tight and don't be afraid, because these guys aren't going anywhere. We got more Monster City coming your way.
Also coming up next, we'll take you down to Hysteria City, where the goblins are green, and you'll find me, Ted Pretty. Aye, aye, aye. That's coming up next, 819, 75 degrees at the Fox 5 Studios, back in 2 minutes.
As day six begins, we get a glimpse of what was. Then our focus turns to what is. Scott and the boys have almost completely transformed these trailers into the haunted city of Hysteria. We've still got a little ways to go, but the bulk of this project is almost complete. When we set this attraction up at Mahoney's Silver Nugget, well, that's when we're gonna put out the really scary stuff. Yeah, that's right, Scott's been holding back. He's got a 45-foot semi-trailer full of scary props ready to go. If you think it's freaky now, you better just open your eyes and get ready for a whole new experience in this city. Looking like some kind of demented freak out of a classic horror flick, George appears from the depths of this monster city. And then reality sets in. He's got an excuse.
I gotta get myself.
And where there's one excuse, there's always another.
Too much shit.
Is he really gonna help this time?
I'm back. Wow, that's just never.
Yeah, that's what they all say. We'll see if those words ring true. While George paints his own future here at Hysteria City, Scott's been busy painting up the ticket trailer. He's even added the ticket taker. As amazing as it may seem, he's even added the skirting to the front of the darkroom facade. The only thing left to do here is set this evil mother up.
The mayor, Mayor Morbid, joins us now. We're taking a look at what's going on in the courtyard right now. And is that Elvis over there?
Yes, he's risen from the grave just for this presentation.
Yeah, like John Huck said a little earlier, I think the only in Vegas will you find a haunted Elvis, I guess.
Yes, the only dead Elvis review here at Hysteria City right here.
It's day seven, and we're moving this bad boy to its new home, the Silver Nugget Casino in Las Vegas. From out of the depths of a dumpster rises a whole new city here in Las Vegas. These semi-trailers have been transformed inside and out, and now they're on their maiden voyage to take you on a journey into the dark side of fear. This evil city will have been built and set up in an amazingly short amount of time. Now, will it be ready to go in time for Halloween? Only Scott knows for sure.
I guess Rome wasn't built in a day. Hysteria City will be built in 10, right here.
I guess the only other question would be, is Elvis really dead? With all the questions answered, I guess it's time to take a look at the finished product, right here in Las Vegas.
There he is.
There he is.
Ted, not looking any better.
Ted, how's the weather today?
Can you guys hear?
Hello?
Can you guys hear me back there?
Yeah, we got you.
I don't know what just happened. I blacked out for a minute there and woke up in the back of a hearse. That's what happens out here at Hysteria City if you're not careful.
Well,
and that ain't, can you hear me?
Yeah, we got you.
Yeah, you look great.
Yeah, that and when you don't know your live shot's coming up. Kind of
yeah, that and when Lee's grabbing some coffee for you guys.
Yeah, that's mine. Right now we are in the Haunted Hotel Lobby, the first room, the first attraction you go through at Hysteria City here in North Las Vegas, right next to the Silver Nugget. Join us right now, once again, Scott Michael, otherwise known, a.k.a. as Mayor Morbid. Tell us about this haunted lobby. I think some house cleaning help needs to be hired, maybe.
Yes, our maids are off duty right now. You're standing in the Hotel Hysteria lobby, built by the eccentric world traveler by the name of Samuel Slaughter. This is where you will check into your final nightmare right here.
And this kicks it all off here. This what's gets the people all scary and all on edge here, on the edge of their seats, so to speak, when they walk through here. The cobwebs, the haunted sculptures, the statues and everything like that really sets the tone for the place. What else can people expect when they walk through the hotel lobby?
Well, basically, you're going to end up in our elevator, which will take you down 13 levels to your final resting place.
So people check in here, but not quite sure on checking out. Hey, another attraction they have here tonight, you can hear the song in the back, Monster Mash, the lead singer, who is?
Bobby Boris Pickett.
And he'll be playing this very song live tonight, is that right?
That's correct, and you can come out and get his autograph as well.
You know the Monster Mash song, Josh, and John is playing in the background right now. Sing along if you can. Hey, we're going to show you more from Hysteria City in North Las Vegas, right next to the Silver Nugget. We'll talk about times and prices coming up. Also, that's later on.